I am sure all of you must have met with a deaf person. And how will you talk with a deaf person? Maybe in your same, in your home, maybe your grandparents, or in your neighborhood, or in the community itself. How will you talk with them? Normally, the tendency is to raise the volume of your sound so that the deaf person can hear sounds better. And even if the deaf hear the TV or the radio, they will increase the volume. And often this is how the parents pick up deafness in a child. That is by increasing the volume of the TV or the sound system. Hearing aid will act in the same way as you increase the sound. So today's class is on hearing aids. Hearing aid. Hearing aid, they work in the same way as they increase the volume of the sound being heard. Okay, discuss the parts of hearing aid, then the types of hearing aid, what are the special features in different hearing aids, what about the fitting, the indications of fitting and things to remember while fitting, and also vibrant sound bridge. This vibrant sound bridge is a commonly asked short note also. Okay, and you cannot avoid hearing aid. Even if you are not an ENT surgeon, then also you will come across this, because sometimes your grandparents will ask to change the battery of it, or they will ask advice, or your neighbors or someone, your friends will come and ask about the doubts of hearing aids. So coming to the parts of hearing aid, I told hearing aids will increase the volume of sound. It amplifies. So actually it acts as an amplifier. So when a person hears sound, this hearing aid will pick up the sound by means of a microphone. Okay. And this microphone will convert the sound waves into electrical impulses, and they are given to an amplifier. Okay, and this amplifier, obviously it will amplify the electrical impulses and again change the electrical impulses into sound waves. And these sound waves, this amplified sound waves are given to a speaker or a receiver. Okay, and it is given to the deaf person who hears an amplified sound. So these are the parts of a hearing aid, and this hearing aid is an electrical device which work by a battery. Okay, so there is a battery also. So these are the parts, and this battery can be a conventional hearing aid battery or a rechargeable battery. Okay, so these are the parts of a hearing aid, and there are a wide variety of hearing aid. Depending on, there are variations in the price, the type of hearing aid, then the special features on that. Then according to the brands, like your mobile phone, there are so many different types of hearing aids. This hearing aid can be of air conduction type and also bone conduction type. Bone conduction, and instead of the ear insert, there is a vibrator which snugly fits into the mastoid area of the patient, and it will vibrate the cochlea directly and the patient will hear. Bone conduction aids are used when there is ear canal atresia or the stenosis of the ear canal, or there is an actively discharging ear, or when there is external otitis, when the ear insert cannot be worn. In that condition we put the bone conduction aid. But the commonly used one is an air conduction aid, which is divided into a canal type. These are the common types of air conduction hearing aid. And the canal type, the entire thing, that is the microphone, the amplifier as well as the speaker, are in a single case, and it is so small that it is seen inside, or it is kept inside the canal without projecting into the congal part. This is the conga. So it will be somewhere inside the canal. Okay, all the thing, and there will be a small thread to take it out. Okay, that is canal like. It is again divided into completely in the canal and in the canal. There are two types. One is completely in the canal, CIC, completely in the canal, and ITC, in the canal. Okay, in both these types, the canal should be large and it should be wide. Large and wide, and the patient should have the minimum dexterity to manipulate very small parts of the hearing aid. And the advantage of this is that it's cosmetically very appealing, and the wind noise. Okay, so it is kept inside the canal, so less likely to catch the wind noise. That is the main advantage. But there are disadvantages also. One, there is earwax. It is kept inside the canal, so there is chance of earwax clogging this hearing aid. And also the battery is very small, so the battery life will be shorter than the other types. And also the special features like a volume controller or a directional microphone will be absent in the canal type, both CIC and ITC. Okay, so the advantage is that it's very small and cosmetically appealing, and also it reduces or cut off the wind noise. But the disadvantage is it is very small thing, so high dexterity to manipulate it is needed. And also the chance of earwax clogging the hearing aid system, and also less battery life, and there is no special features like volume control and this directional microphone. ITC is in the ear. Okay, in the ear. So this is seen in the congal part. The hearing aid will sit here in the conga. Okay, that is in the ear, and this is cosmetically very appealing, and it has got special features. Advantage is that it has got special features like a volume control, and also the directional microphones are inbuilt in that, and battery life is more than that of this type, canal type. Okay, battery is larger, so the life is more, and also there is option for rechargeable battery. So coming to the disadvantages, mainly the wax clogging is a disadvantage, and also it will pick up the wind noise more than that of in the canal type. Okay, so they pick up wind noise, and also the chance of earwax clogging the aid is there. And this in the ear type comes in two types. It is custom made and available in two, full shell and half shell. What is that? Full shell is this type, which one? It will completely seen in the congal part, and the half shell, it will be seen only in the lower half of conga. This is a half shell. Okay, this type. So the ear canal will be seen here. Part of ear canal will be seen outside. And half shell, it is seen in the lower half of conga. Okay, it is more cosmetically appealing than a full shell. And it is custom made also, and color can be given according to the body color of the patient. Okay, what is this BTE? That is behind the ear. So the your microphone, amplifier, as well as a speaker and battery unit is kept in a single piece, which is hooked in the hellishere part, and the rest will. This is the part unit, and that will rest in the behind the ear, and this is connected to the ear canal or to an ear mold using a small wire or plastic wire. Okay, and this is suitable for, appropriate for all ages and also all type of hearing loss. And there is it's larger than the completely in the canal, and the manipulations are easier than a smaller type. But the disadvantage is that it will pick up wind noise. Okay, that is the main disadvantage of this. A smaller version of behind the ear is RIC. This is RIC. What is that? Receiver in the canal. Or otherwise we can call it as a mini BTE. Okay, the receiver in the canal. In this, This part is very small. It will sit in the upper part of ear, and it is connected to a very small ear insert. Very small ear insert. Okay, like this. And this ear insert is kept inside the ear canal. So the visibility is less. Then the other advantages are almost the same. That is, there is volume control, there is directional microphone, and the manipulations are easy. But it will pick up wind noise, and also there is chance of this receiver clog with wax. Okay, these are the disadvantages, but it is better than behind the ear, this RIC, and it is especially preferable for high frequency sensory neural loss, especially in case of presbyopia. This open fit is a variation of behind the ear, and the behind the ear, I said, there is a part in the conga which is custom made. But in open fit, actually we keep the external auditory canal open, so that what is the advantage? Low frequency sound will reach the ear naturally, and amplification occurs only for high frequency sounds. Okay, so what is the main advantage? The own voice will appear better for the patient. Okay, the own voice will be heard better. The low frequency voices, low frequency sound will reach the ear naturally, and only the high frequency sound get amplified. But the difficulty is that this is the external auditory canal, and here there will be a non-custom made lobe. It is not custom made, it is non-custom made. So the visibility will be more, and it is cosmetically not that much appealing. But the main advantage is that the natural low frequency sound will be heard naturally. So that is the open fit. And what about the body worn? Body worn is an older type, maybe the earliest type of hearing aid. You have seen your grandparents, not your grandparents, my grandparents, wore it with the pocket type. It is like that. The whole the amplifier, the microphone amplifier receiver battery system is kept in one and with a clip. This clip is put into the pocket, and the ear insert is through a wire loop. It is connected to the ear. Okay, that is a body worn. It is also very good hearing aid. The lowest cost, it comes around 1500 to 2000 Indian rupee, and the manipulations are very easy. The battery has got a very long life. Even now the rechargeable batteries are available for body worn, but cosmetically it is not at all agreeable. Okay, that is the main disadvantage of this body worn type. These are the different types of hearing aids available, and you can see all the types here. This is the body worn type of hearing aid, where there is an on off switch, and also there is a volume control. See, the volume can be increased or decreased with that. And it has got a battery, which is a conventional hearing aid battery, and got a very good battery life. And this is a receiver which can be inserted into the ear, and it is a clip which can be clipped to your pocket or to your kurta or anywhere. And this is the oldest type, and this is completely in the canal, this hearing aid, and it has also got a battery insert. This is where you put the battery, but the battery life is very less, around 5 to 7 days only, and it has got an wire loop for insertion into the ear. And this is the receiver in the canal, RIC. Okay, it is a modification of behind the ear type, but it is smaller than, and it is cosmetically more appealing than behind the ear. This is behind the ear, BTE. You can see that the everything inside a plastic mold, which is pulled behind the ear and connected to the canal through a ear insert, and that it has got a volume control also. And the Siemens type of RIC has got volume control, and this is Widex, and this Widex type model RIC has no volume control, and it has to be programmed using a computer.
And this CIC also has no volume control, and it comes in a programmable or a digital type. Actually, this behind the ear or BTE can be used for moderate to severe type of hearing loss, and it suits well for that actually. And it is more bulky than a RIC or other types. Okay. And this is a in the ear type, ITE. Okay. And this part will come and fill the congal area. It also has got a volume control, and there is also a area for inserting the battery. And this battery life is a little more better than the completely in the canal type. You can compare the size of this ITE with the CIC. See? And this ITE can be custom made. Can be made as per the color of your skin color. Okay.
Special features. What are the special features available? One is noise reduction or wind reduction. Okay. Wind reduction. I said except for the completely in the canal, there is chance of this sound of wind coming and causing difficulty in hearing. So noise or wind reduction methods are available. Then there is directional microphones. What is that directional microphone? That is microphone in a single hearing aid. There will be two microphones to take different sound coming from anteriorly or from behind or from the opposite side. So the microphone direction will change with the multiple microphones available or set in a single unit. The patient can identify the location of the sound. Okay, that is the advantage. And the third one is rechargeable battery. That is rechargeable batteries. Okay. And fourth one is telecoils. So it will be easy for the patient or better hearing for the patient while talking in a telecoil compatible telephones are available. Wireless connectivity. Wireless connectivity. That is wireless compatibility with a Bluetooth compatible cell phone or a music player. And but you need an intermediary device to connect the cell phone or the music player with a hearing aid. That is available. And remote control facility. Remote control, that is each time there is no need to take out the hearing aid for volume control and on and off. That can be controlled with a remote control device. And then there is synchronization. What is that? Synchronization methods. That is when the same patient using two hearing aid, the each one can be synchronized with that of the other side using the remote control synchronization device which is fitted into the hearing aid. Then there is direct audio input. Okay. Direct audio input, that is especially in a noisy surrounding like a theater or a crowded environment, the audio from the device can be directly connected to the hearing aid either through a wire system or by wireless connectivity. So these are some of the special features which is available with the various types of hearing aid. There are also two types of aid which are analog or programmable aids. Analog aid or a programmable aid. And digital aid. What is this analog aid? In an analog aid, the sound waves are converted to electrical impulses and then they are amplified. So this is custom built, custom made by the manufacturer for each user according to the specifications given by the audiologist. Okay, So there is an analog or there is a program, and this program circuitry can be included in all type of hearing aid. Okay, the analog type, and this program is set up in the hearing aid using a software by the audiologist. And not only one program, but more than one, that is two or three types of programs can be installed into each hearing aid, and that will, according to the listening environment of the patient can change that. Okay, that is from a small quiet, if the patient is sitting in a small quiet environment, there is one program, and if he is going to a very crowded environment, there is a noisy environment in a crowd background, the patient can change the program. It is like that. Hope you got it. There is two or three programs and that can be changed. And it is less expensive than the digital aid. Okay. And what is what about the digital aid? In the analog type, I told you, the sound frequencies are converted to electrical impulses. And then they are amplified. But in the digital aid, the sounds are converted to numerical codes. Like the binary codes you use in a computer, the sound sounds are converted to numerical codes, and then they are amplified. So what is the advantage of that? The numerical codes contains information about the pitch and also the frequency of sound. So according to the need of the patient, this can select different pitch. So the specific pitch and also the specific frequency of the voice can be, or the sound can be controlled. Clarity of sound can be much more better with a digital aid, and there the audiologist has the flexibility to pick up the specific frequency of, or the intensity of sound needed for the patient, and that can be adjusted inside. And this digital circuitry can also incorporated in all type of hearing aids. And but it is costly, much more expensive than all other types of hearing aids. Yeah. Coming to the fitting, what are the indications? This hearing aid can be fitted in all type of hearing loss, whether it is sensory neural, conductive or mixed type. In a conductive hearing loss, we prefer surgery. But hearing aids are preferred when the patient refuses to do a surgery, or when the surgery is not feasible, or when there is recurrence after surgery. An example is otosclerosis. You have done a stapedectomy and then there is a recurrence, or there is some other problem. And then in that case, you can advise hearing aid. So, sensory neural hearing loss, conductive hearing loss, provided surgery is not feasible or not done, and also mixed type of hearing loss. But there is only one absolute indication for hearing aid fitting, and that is a congenitally deaf child for proper development of speech and language. That is the only one absolute indication. In all cases of congenital deaf child, you have to advise, or you have to make the child fit a hearing aid, then only the proper development of speech and language will happen. Things to remember, or what are the things to advise to the patient, what are the things to be planned before fitting a hearing aid. That is, one is type of hearing loss, that is important. Then the degree of hearing loss, and also the type of frequency, the configuration of hearing, that is important. Which frequencies are affected, especially if you are planning for a digital aid. Then the age and dexterity of the patient is important. Then the cost of the device. Don't think that the higher the price, the quality will be more. Don't think like that. Always go looking with the service provided by the company. That is very important. And also the life and also the other features. And if you are looking for special features, think of a brand which suits them better. And the type of the side of fitting, whether it is monaural, whether it is binaural, or there is a Y connector. Always cross, what is that? Contralateral routing of signals. Think that one here, my right side is completely deaf and you are putting the receiver on the left side. So the microphone is kept on the severely deaf side. so that the sound coming, localization will be much better. Sound coming from that side will be picked up by the microphone and it is routed to the opposite side where the receiver is kept. That is contralateral routing of signals to be considered before prescribing a hearing aid. And remember, these hearing aids are best suited for patients with conductive hearing loss, not in a sensorineural hearing loss. Why? In a sensorineural hearing loss, there is chance of recruitment coming into play. Recruitment. Okay. Maybe the patient must have told you, when I put a hearing aid, I see hear a shrieking sound or a whistling sound. That is because of the recruitment. But in the newer aids have methods to lower the recruitment. When, what are the methods? One is peak clipping. Peak clipping of sound. And then there is automatic volume control. Automatic volume controls can be integrated. And third, compression amplification. Okay. Compression amplification. All these are methods to reduce recruitment while putting hearing aids in a case of sensorineural hearing loss. Next is this one. Vibrant sound bridge. What is this? It is actually a semi-implantable hearing aid. It has got two parts. It has got an outer external component. This is an external component which is an audio processor. And an internal component is called a VORP. Okay, vibrating ocular processes. And it has got three parts. One is a receiver, then a floating mass transducer, and a link between these two, that is a conductor. So this external component has got a microphone which is linked with the internal component by radio frequencies across the skin. Okay. And for this, we have to do a cortical mastoidectomy and posterior temporotomy approach. Go and reach the long processor fincus. And this floating mass transducer is attached to the long processor fincus. Okay, so what happened? When a sound, on transmitting a sound, this directly it vibrates the long processor fincus or the ocular system, bypassing the external auditory canal as well as the tympanic membrane. So it will directly stimulate the cochlea and the whole other system gets stimulated. This is preferred in case of all types of hearing losses, especially mild to moderate, and also in conductive hearing loss where surgery cannot be done, or when the ear insert type or behind the ear of type of hearing aids are not preferred. Okay, and it has got very good advantage. One is it has got a very good sound quality even in noisy surroundings. Then there is no problem with wax formation, and the battery life is very high, and the feedback is less, and also there is high gain, that is good voice quality. That is the main advantage of this. Okay, so that is the vibrant sound bridge, which is an implantable middle ear device. Baha, that is bone anchored hearing aid. It is actually a type of bone conduction aid which bypasses the external auditory canal and the tympanic membrane, and it directly stimulates the cochlea. Along with the bone conduction aid, I said we put a vibrator which fits snugly into the mastoid. If that is that may cause severe discomfort to the patient, and in that cases we can prefer this bone anchored hearing aid, especially in cases of severe canal stenosis, canal atresia, or conductive losses where surgery is contraindicated or there is no chance of doing a surgery, or post-operated surgical failures. In all these, we can prefer this Baha. Here it has got a titanium fixture. This titanium fixture is embedded into the skull bone, and it takes around 2 to 6 months for the osseointegration, and after that a titanium abutment Okay. That is linked to the titanium fixture through the skin, and this abutment actually, this will be the abutment, and this is the fixture and this is the abutment, and to that we give a external processor is attached to this titanium abutment. Okay, so this is surgically implanted into the skull bone, and after 2 to 6 months we get an osseointegration with the surrounding tissue, and then we put the titanium abutment, and this is attached to this, and this is exposed outside, and to that we put an external processor. Okay, audio processor. So when the sound reaches, it directly stimulates the cochlea. But in a vibrant sound bridge, this part is implanted into the long prosopharyngeus. That is the main difference between these two. And this is very much useful in case of conductive hearing loss, and also in unilateral severe sensorineural hearing loss where there is contralateral routing of signals is needed. So we put the microphone as well as amplifier on the side of severe deafness, and the receiver is kept on the other side. Okay, so that is also very much useful if we in that cases also we prefer a bone anchored hearing aid. And the only complication comes here is there is failure of osseointegration, and there is chance of infection and inflammation of the tissue. So that is regarding the hearing aid. We talked about all these, the parts, types, special features, fitting and vibrant sound bridge, and along with that also we talked about Baha. Okay, thank you.